Hi and welcome to my guide on how to play World of Warcraft. Today I'll show you a little bit about cities. Now there are cities near every starting point. For the humans, it's going to be Stormwind, also known as SW. Okay, when you approach a city, you'll see a guard. Now if you click on the guard will tell you where most things can be found, such as professional class trainer, flight path master, auction house, bank, etc. It's all mainly found here. Now what I will start doing in my videos, including little tags, just showing what abbreviations and different words mean, what they're used for in World of Warcraft. Anyway, moving on. Today we're going to choose auction house, just for this demonstration. Okay, it'll bring up a little red flag on your minimap, or a little yellow arrow, if it's not in the immediate area. So, we want to go to that little flag. If you press M on your main map, it'll show you where to go. The flag's here. Your main map may look different if you don't have Cartographer. If you do, it should look like this. Or you can set it to look like this if you like. Okay, so we have the auction house. If you have Auctioneer, it comes handy with this. And I'll show you why in a second. Okay, so you click on any of the auctioneers available. And under name, you type in what you're looking for, if you know what you're looking for. If not, you could search here. So say for example, I want a bag. Because I'm running out of bag space, sorry. And so we just click on bag and hit search. Now with Auctioneer, if it already is aware of the average price, it'll give you a percentage. Here. And that way you know if you're purchasing the item for too much, or you're getting a good deal. So, you also have auctions. Down here, it shows you all the auctions you currently have listed. And if you don't have Auctioneer, this is how you list your items to sell. So, you get something out of your bag, you put it here. You choose your starting price, so what the minimum amount people can bid on. You list whether you want it for 12 hours, 24 hours, or 48 hours, noticing that the deposit will be different for each selection. And you also choose a buyout price if you want. With the buyout price, it's what people will pay to get that item immediately. Now, if you do sell something, you'll get a little message saying that someone's brought something, but you need to wait an hour before you get the money for it, or gold. Then if you have Auctioneer, you go to Appraiser. This is how you list items with Auctioneer. So what you do, you put your little stack or item in the slot there and you press refresh. Now if it's a decent price, you can post items or wait till later. You can also select items here in this little menu here and refresh and post items. So that's pretty much it. And I'll also show you the bank. Now I will go into guild dynamics and different guild types later on, probably in my next few videos. I have been asked about it, and yeah, I am a guild leader myself, so I'll run through a little bit about it. Okay, so here we are at the bank. Now we have a guild vault. If you are in a guild, this is where what you can access. Depending on your guild type, what rank you are, you may not be able to withdraw items, you may be able to deposit items, you may not. You may not even be able to view them. It depends on the bank you're in and who you are, really. Okay, so next we go to your own personal bank space, where it lets you deposit items that you may want to keep for later. Or fill up your bag space. Oh, yeah, get rid of your filled up bag space. Okay, when you run out of room in your bank's slot here, you could purchase more bag spaces. Now once you have a bag space, you just deposit a bag. That's all you need to do. Okay, now, yeah, that's it. Let's see. I can't think of anything else to say here, so I'll pretty much wrap it up now. If there's any questions, leave a comment below or send me a message. If it's not too silly, I will respond to it. Anyway, have a great day.